So we shall begin with the business intelligence second topic. Let me share the screen. So the topic name it is a Baldrige Excellence Framework, where you can use your business for the purpose of competence. Getting so to attain that competences, you are supposed to manage this. You are supposed to manage the seven keys here, otherwise seven important points. So what you have to do it is, let us have a look once again the structure of this Baldrige Excellence Framework. Here the Baldrige Business Excellence Framework, you have the seven keys. Those are the leadership, strategic planning, customer and market focus, then after that measurement, analysis and knowledge focus, workforce focus, process management and results. If you follow this, all the seven keys, you are able to achieve your business organization very well in an excellence way, where you can gain the points. The way I had told you, the college has participated for the NAC purposes. So NAC is not only of your students' performance, not only of the staff details. It is going to check entire all the things that is a infrastructure or any other things which is included for the purpose of that criteria. Okay, so here you will can see the first one, second one and third one. This first one is a leadership, second one is a strategic planning, and the third one it is what, customer focus, where these all three things are under the category of leadership. This is one triad. Okay, triad means what, three things are there, TRAID. And after that, last one, measurement, analysis, and knowledge management. This is a separate part. Last here, workforce focus, operation focus, and the result. This is one more triad, which is called as a results. So fourth one, which is a measurement, analysis, and knowledge, that is completely independent. So two triads are there with the people. That is one triad of leadership and second triad of a result. So today we will begin with the separate points of the Baldrige Excellence Framework, where you have to apply. So that you have to go on checking it. Okay. Normally, if still people are getting confusion, where will be this implemented? Let me give you a brief and small example. Now, for this academic year, the respective GS and LS has been elected. So for that purpose, those both LS, GS, what they have to do for this academic year, what all events they are going to organize, what all for that event's purpose, what is their goal, what is the objective, and how that objective is going to get implemented, that should be done. Other example, I can say your live project also it is there. Your planning should be there, and your goal should be there, objectives. After that, how you're going to deploy or develop, everything will come here. So let us see today one by one. I have made it easy for you people, where I have given a small pictures. With the help of that, you can understand here. This all the Baldrige Excellence Framework you are supposed to use for business here. So the first key, leadership. Can anyone tell me what is the leadership, where it will be applied? Anyone, according to you, your own definition, I can get it. Anyone? Manisha? Yes, Manisha? You can tell me what is the leadership? Others, Sonam, according to you, what is the leadership? I'm not going to ask for this Indana and this word Chetan. The last priority I'm going to give for them. Yes.
For example, ma'am, in our class, we are having a CR and LR, sir. So okay. They are the leaders, means they have the abilities to take care of all. They take the queries of others. Okay. They can, means they have that ability to take care of all.
Oh.
That means they are leaders, I guess.
Fine. Sanjana, according to you, what is the leadership? What is your goal? What is your objective? What do you want to do?
Ma'am, I think leadership means the one who should have all the qualities of management, and at the same time decision making is also important, and should make sure that it should not go against everybody's will.
Yes, exactly.
It should be a 50-50 ratio of both the factors.
Okay, correct. So here in the business, maybe organization, no matter whether it is a small organization or a large organization, everywhere there is a one leader. With the help of leader, your business will grow. Someone senior should be there here. Leaving them, your company will never work here. If there is an absence of the leadership, kind of it will work. But someone experienced also should be there here. So in this Baldrige Excellence Framework, what leadership specifies that? Who is the leader of your company or organization? What quality he or she has, how she or he is managing everything. So here we have given here, describes how personal actions of the organizations of your company or organization, how the respective he or she is going to take action for any kind of a project for your company or for your organization. All this will come as a planning, then market, customer, everything will come here. Then what comes after this? It is what organizations, senior it is there. Seniors, leaders guide and sustain the organization, fulfill its social, ethical and legal responsibility. First of all, you are supposed to take a senior guide who is the main person of this company, like a founder or like a director or like a CEO. That guide should be there. And after taking the guide of those people, you are supposed to think how you are going to achieve or fulfill the organization's goal. Maybe it is a social or it is an ethical or legal responsibility. Every employee or every people of a company, they are working for their purpose. It's kind of a work that is being given task. So how they are going to manage that task, how the training will be given to them. Now you join the company, Wipro or Infosys, you are not going to give the people of the any trainers. They will not give you only laptop or Sankaro. No, it is not. Someone should be there to train you. So that is what, who is that? The leader. That is the leader here. So again, in this two part, in the leadership, you people have two ways. One, it is a senior leadership, and another, it is what, governance and social responsibility. The word itself specifies that senior leadership. And the governance means what? How your, whether your company is being legally specified or no, whether it is promoted or no, properly having any proper license or no. So that should be done. So let us have a look. Let me discuss here what exactly the senior leadership here. The job of the senior leadership is what, guide the organization. I'll give you an example. This is what our HOD is, this what senior leadership is there here. He will guide you. Both LSGS here, how he is going to guide, how you are going to manage all the events, how you are going to take care of all the classes, how you are going to take care of the ladies department, what actions has to be taken for the ladies side, what actions has to be taken socially. Everything is being done by the senior leadership. The job of the senior leadership is what, guide the organization. If your company is there, how your company will be guided, what all things should be managed, that is there here. In second point, it is what, create a sustainable organization. Your organization should be in a proper way so that the employees are also comfortable getting to work with you all. It should not be like uncomfortable or unsatisfied. Whoever the employee or whoever the person is working in your company should be very happy for that to work here. Everything should be provided. So that is what a sustainable organization. Then third point of the senior leadership specifies that communicate and motivate employees. Communicate and motivate employees. It is not only the communication to be happened with the TL, team leader. No, it is not. The senior's leadership responsibility is that he or she has to communicate with each and every employee of the company or the organization. What problem he or she is facing or what he is not able to understand. If your employee is not working properly, someone should be there to motivate him or her. So this is also the responsibility of the leadership. And the last one, it is what? focus on organizational performance. Yes, in the companies or in the organization, some targets will be there, right? So for that target, how everyone is achieving team wise, teamwork, whether the team leader is working or no, whether the boss is working or no, everything has to be maintained. Whether the customers are coming properly or no, everything to be taken care of by the this what leadership. Leadership means he or she is not only the person to do all this job. Just have a look for the company employee communication should be there and the performance also should be there. So this is the work of your senior leadership here. So they have said, you can see here the picture, leadership, what are the responsibilities or what are the functions, power. He should be away where he has the ability to take the decision and decide what has to be done. So that power should be there here. Skills are required. Motivation should be there. Should be a responsible person. Teamwork should be there. Communication, competence, and support. The second one here, governance and social responsibility. Now, here in the senior leadership, it is of only of the company, how to guide the company or how to guide the organization. Take care of your employees and with the help of communication and motivation, check whether the organization is working properly or no, like infrastructure and all. That should be focused. And the last one, it is what performance of your company, what goal you had decided and whether you are achieving that or no, that is the job of the leadership. Come to the main second point, governance and social responsibility. What is that here? Here, the main job, it is what addressing organizational governance. They will say, no, that do you have a license or no, whether your company is being authorized or no, authentication is there or no. So that should be there here. They have said that addressing organizational governance, which means transparency in operations and disclosure practices. Transparency in operations means what alternatives you can take here for the operation purpose. I can say this for day shift, night shift, how the work should be there here. Okay? And then accountability for management's actions. Accountability, the word accountability comes means it is a finance. Okay? Here in the governance and social responsibility, those people, government people, they will come like to check the business, how your finance department is getting managed, what amount you have given for the company infrastructure, what amount you are paying for the employees, what amount you are paying for the this what workers, I mean this floor workers, everything, how you are going to manage, what amount you are giving for the resources like a laptop, then current, inverter, everything will come here. So that is the accountability for management's action here. Evaluating, next one, evaluating the performance of CEO and the members of the governance board. The main thing, it is what, who is the founder of the company, who is the founder of, CEO of the company, that also you are supposed to check whether the CEO is working properly or no, whether the performance is getting work or no, how the CEO has planned, director or CEO has planned the goal or objective, it is getting worked according to that or no, schedule wise or no. So that also will come under the governance and social responsibility here. And then promoting legal and ethical behavior, support of key communicators here. Right now, promoting your legal and ethical behavior, I can give you the example of the live today's now in this pandemic period. Today itself, I mean from the 10th May to 24th May, again the lockdown has been increased. So what they have said, everything is being closed, only essential things are getting worked from the 6 to 10. Here, that is a this word, promoting legal and ethical behavior is done, but the legal things, what can be worked, what cannot be worked here. So I can give the example as a banking sectors or hospital sectors. Now some of the employees are working for the banking. The normal rule is what, nobody should come out of the house or from 10 a.m. to the next day. So if anybody comes, you are supposed to have a license. For what purpose you are going to come? Simply, we are not supposed to go out and roam here. So that time, what happens? Whoever the employees are there, the people, employees working as a doctor or a banker, they should have a respective authorized ID. If they have an ID, then they have a ability to go out to work anywhere here. marketing. So this is the promoting legal and ethical behavior. And the last one, support of key communities here. Whatever the keys you have decided, goal you have to decide, that should be supported for your achievement purpose here. Okay. So this is your leadership here. Senior leadership only company employees. Governance kya hai? Governance, you are supposed to think of operation, how the working procedure is there of your company, who are working like a day shift and night shift, who is working, what kind of a task that should be disclosed, and accountability means what? Management of your finance, everything in your company, how it is getting working. And the main point is what? Evaluating the performance of CEO. That will come under the governance and social responsibility. So this is the first point of the Balaji's excellence framework, leadership. Okay. Second point is what? Strategic planning. You yourself have a look and let me know. Here the first point, only deciding is done of your leadership. Abhi tak kuch kaam nahi shuru ho gaya. Now here, you have to think now here. Yes, the strategic planning. Here is being decided. Example for more, your projects. Your project title has been decided. Synopsis also ready. Right? Only you have decided. Not yet started anything. I have to do this topic, so and so. Hospital management system, so and so. The thing I have decided. What laptop I have taken, that I have done. On what language I have decided, that I have done. Then where printing I have to take, which course I have to do, everything has been done. Only deciding is done. Yet. Here, you have to start working. Strategic planning. Here you can have a look. First of all, the picture. What all things are there? Goal should be there here. Everywhere the goal will come. Then desired strategies, measures and targets and results here. Goal should be there. Where do we want to go? What kind of a project you are going to do? Desired outcomes. You have decided whether it will work or no. I mean, it should come with respect to output here. How do we get there here? What are the strategies? What planning you have done? How you are going to implement? Measures and targets. How you are going to do the measurement? How long you have taken to work out the coding part of login, username and password? That measurement should be there. Then what is the result? How can we improve? Everywhere it is a this word round and round. Goals, desired outcomes, strategies, measures and targets, results. Still improvement should be there. Come to this point now. What exactly the strategic planning is here? It is the examines how the organization develop its strategic objectives and how these objectives are implemented here. Strategic means what? You are from small organization to the global organization. You will decide, no, my first goal is to finish all the giving the synopsis or title of the project. The first goal is of completing the login page. That objective should be there. So strategic objective, whenever the strategic planning comes, you have to keep in mind three things are there. Three goals will be there. Short term, then middle term goal and long term goal here. So these three goals are there. What are your goals? How you are going to achieve weekly, monthly, quarterly, yearly? What are your goals? Everything should be there. Okay. So then, objectives and how these objectives are implemented here. Two things are there again, strategy development and strategy deployment here. Strategy development means what? You have to decide. Working should be there here. And deployment means what? Execution should be there here. The way you will write your Java program or any other programs are there, you will start typing the program. You will develop that project, build the project. Then you will say this word execute, which means what? Whether your project is getting executed properly or no. So let us see two things are there. The strategies development. What will come under the strategy development? Not development, deployment here. determination of key strategic objectives with timelines. Target should be there here. Your project has been started. Now we have given the task to title should be submitted so and so date. Then synopsis should be submitted so and so date. You are supposed to go with the coding part with a deadline. You are supposed to go with the designing part with a respective deadline. Testing should be done here. Validation, verification. For your respective business or for your respective project, there is an objective and deadline or timelines are there. Within a specific period of time, you are supposed to finish the task. So that is one. Balancing the need of all the stakeholders. Now, whatever I'm talking, it is according to the business. Balancing all the needs of all the stakeholders here. Who are the stakeholders? Who are working for your company or who are the outsiders here? How you are going to manage them? What are the needs? How you are, if you have 100 stakeholders or employees, who will take care of that? How you are going to manage each and every employee? Then assessing organization strength, weakness, opportunities and threats. The respective companies or organization, you are supposed to find out what is the strength, what is the weakness, what are the opportunities if you are going to start this business, what opportunities will come. So that is there. And what are the threats also here? Who will be threatening you? So that also matters. Business matlab sirf profit nahi hota. Business can be this what in loss also. Whenever you are in the loss, you should have an ability to come up. So that should be there here. Okay. Then here comes the finding of the strength, weakness, opportunities, and threats, and risk assessment. Somewhere in the company's risk also will be there here. So that risk also should be achieved very properly here. Okay. Changes. Then one more point, strategy development. Changes in technology trends, markets, competition, and regulatory environment here. Yes, the technology is getting increased everywhere. More things are getting worked out for that purpose. Also, you should be aware. Know what? As I will be telling the example, 10 years or 20 years back, whenever we were used to use the go to the grocery shop, the bill was used to give in a handwritten, right? But today, if you see, today, there is a printed bill. What? Why? Why is that? Because of the technology has been increased, because of the technology trend is getting worked out everywhere. Digital era is becoming. Today, in this lockdown period, the banking sectors have been increased more for becoming digital, digitally payment, because otherwise we were used to go to the respective bank, stand in the queue, whatever the transaction was there, whether it is a withdraw or whether it is a deposit. But today, what? Everyone is having a smartphone, and with the help of that, the payment system is also getting worked out, whether it is a GPay or PhonePe, right? You are not supposed to visit outside. There is a no cash payment here. Everywhere, cashless payment is going on. Why? Because of the technology trends are there here. Okay. So this will come in the strategy development. Come to the next point, which is a strategy deployment here. Yes. Action plan development. Whatever we have decided in the development part, which was the strategy. Now, I told you that changes in technology trends. Assume that you are having a shop or an organization, company it is there, where your transactions are getting done cash. You are taking a cash amount manually. Hand. Okay. Then what happens? Machine was got utilized where we can swipe the cards. So to start the swiping of the cards, what you should have? You should have a respective that machine, right? So that implementing machine or that implement working of that machine, getting that machine should be done in what? Deployment. वहाँ पे सिर्फ decide हो गया आपका. Deployment क्या करना है? Actually, you are supposed to implement. Now, recent, 1 year back itself, in every shop, there is a phone pay. We will take the mobile phone, we will scan the QR code, payment. हो गया. What they had done? Changes it is worked here. And deployment means what? They have to create that QR code and start working. So that is what the strategy deployment here. Then after that, yes, I just now have told you that if you want to start the payment as a phone pay or GPay, you should have all the things. You are supposed to create that QR code and keep. Okay. Now listen to the point next. Allocating resources for accomplishment of the action plan. allocating the resources. As I have told you that a few days back or few years back, the payment was getting with the help of cash amount देते थे. तो हमने क्या decide किया? अभी swiping का काम करेंगे, right? So to swipe the card, what you require? You should have that respective machine. So that machine has come under what? Resources, which is called as a allocating resources for accomplishment of that action plan. आपने decide किया है payment अभी swiping card से हो जाएगा. Payment अभी फोन पे या जीपे से हो जाएगा. So for that purpose, what you need? You are supposed to create a QR code to take that printout. Resource should be there, no? That is what called as a accomplishment or deployment. Then allocating human resources to accomplish short term or long term goals here. Sometimes what happens to the company, goals will be there. So you have to go on deciding what are the goals, which is a short goal, short term goal, or achievement. Thoda achievement hai, weekly or monthly, everything. For that purpose, you are supposed to hire the employees. Not hire, whoever are there in your company, you are supposed to give them a task. So yeah, yes. Sanjana, this is your task. You are supposed to collect all the names. So and so yes. Sandhya, your task is of what? Margin. What is her goal? Long term goal. It is this. What entire year margin she has to do. Short term will come as a collecting every month small articles here. Then short term goals. Let me give you one more example. Chetan and Sanjana, short-term goal will be like an in-house event or code zone activities will be there. So that will come under the short-term. What is a long-term goal for them? Evosion, right? I'm giving a just example. Don't take it serious. Evosion is a long-term goal. So for them, they have to decide the moment they had become this for GS and LSA. Otherwise, they might have started previous year also. Hamara ye goal hoga, hum aise karenge, waise karenge, improve karenge. So that is what the long-term goal. Short-term is what monthly. Now it is not possible, but I'm giving. This will happen, short-term goal. Okay. So for that purpose, allocating human resource to accomplish short-term goal and long-term goal. If Chetan and Sadhana has decided to start a code zone activity, so they are not going to take both. They both will ask for other friends who will take the workshop for this subject. So this is the short-term goal, and for that they are asking their friends here. So that is there. And the long-term goal means what? Big evolution should be there. So that is. Then next one, developing performance measures or indicators for tracking the effectiveness and achievement of the action plan. Yeah, the last one, it is whatever you have decided, no, you are supposed to check whether it is getting work out or no, whether it is getting affected or no. Are the students happy or no? I mean, if you have started a short-term goal of organizing a code zone activity for 3 days or 2 days workshop, you have to think whether it will be effective for your friends or no, whether it will get implemented or no in the future. Everything matters, okay? And then the last one, it is what? Performance projection means what? Addressing current gaps in performance with respect to competition. I'll explain you. Performance projection means what here? Assume that your companies or organization this year, otherwise what example I'll give? Yes, the lockdown period. Before the lockdown period, most of the business were in a good profit, right? But once the lockdown was started from the last year, what happened? Some of the businesses came down. So some businesses came down, and after that, again to pick up the business, that time you are supposed to compare where you had lost, what was your level, and what increased level has become here. So that we have said that performance projection addressing current gaps in performance with respect to competition here. What is the gap here? Where you are lacking? If your neighbor company or organization is a higher level, performance is very good, and you are low, kind of low here. You are supposed to find out where you are lucky, where you are getting loosed, where you are becoming lower and lower. So that should be there in this what? Deployment also here. So this is the strategic planning. Second point, it is done. Then third one, customer focus. Now let me give you a chance to think about the customer focus here. Can anyone try for the customer focus? You can have a look for this picture. Entire picture is there with you people. Very easiest, not that difficult. Anmol? Yes, Anmol? Anyone? Deepika?
Hello, ma'am.
Yes.
The customer focus is nothing but focusing on the quality on service and the reliability of the product.
Again.
And even the service provided by the
Yes, by the services being provided by the what? Can anyone complete the point of Deepika, Sanjana?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Customer focus is directly proportional to the relationship with the customer and the satisfaction of that customer's needs. So they cater to what the customer wants. So that is what means by customer focus.
Yes, exactly. So here, that leadership is being done by the main leader here, and then strategy. That is a part of entire company, organization. Now, customer means what? If you are going to start a business, of course, you need a customer. People should come, no? So, you are supposed to check what are the needs of the customer, what kind of product they want. Still, improvement should be there or what? So, here you can see your picture. This is what keeps the customer happy. Yes, always satisfaction should be there. The customer is the king. 100% quality you are supposed to give. Your quality should be very good. Services, reliability, and satisfaction. Time response. Yes, if you said today I will deliver, you have to deliver today means today. You are supposed to think how you are going to do that. Continuously improve the customer experience. Easy or she happy or no. Value the customer's opinion. Take a feedback. Service with the customer. Then customer is always right. You are not supposed to get in parallel with the customer. Personal interaction should be there. You have to take a feedback of the customer of not only the products or any other things also here. So let us have a look here. Now, according to this, determines the customer's requirements, what customer exactly wants. As I had told you the example, Patanjali, right? The Patanjali store was there where only there this one. Makeup kit and all they were used to sell. So one of the customer will come and they will tell that you people please start selling the other products also, grocery thing. So that is what the customer feedback. Okay. You are supposed to take the requirement. Build the customer relationship, like maintaining the relationships. Those customers should visit your shop only. That kind of a relation should be done. Okay. You should not lose the customer. Then and uses the customer feedback to improve and identify new opportunities for innovation. Of course, you know what? Innovation should be there. Opportunities also should be there. You know, if one of the shop, example you take out of this one, in city itself, one retail shop or grocery shop where is being handled by the old people, I mean senior citizen. So those people will be only managing the manually. No, all the receipt and all that. So somewhere the customer itself will be there. They will tell those people, uncle or auntie, you can start this idea. We can help you. So for them, it is a new idea. So that also should be there. They have said that identify new opportunities for innovation also. Then here, 2 points are there. For everything, here two points are there. Here first one, customer and market knowledge. Okay. What are the customer and market knowledge? Identification and determination of target customers and market segments here. what is the identification? I mean, what you can identify for your current customers. Are they happy or no? Still, what they need or what? Yes, so that should be there. And market segment. Segments means what outside, what is trending is going on. According to that, you have to go. What the customers are making interested nowadays more. That should be there. Okay. Then using the feedback to become more focused and satisfy customer needs here. In this market knowledge also, you have to take the feedback of every customer. Are they happy or no? Or we should improve ourselves for what here. So that is there. And the second point, main second point specifies that customer relationship and satisfaction. Acquire new customers, meet and exceed customers' expectations here. Take the new customers. Don't stick to that regular customers here, current customers. Make your marketing more. Make your sales more here so that more number of customers will come here. Give them satisfaction. Meet their requirement. There is a lot of difference between customer and market knowledge and the customer relationship and satisfaction. Here, what you have to do, customer and market knowledge, जो भी आपके पास करंट कस्टमर है उनका नीड्स देखना है आपको. कस्टमर रिलेशनशिप व्हाट इट इज देयर हियर, यू हैव द करंट कस्टमर आल्सो, ट्राई टू फाइंड आउट द न्यू कस्टमर्स आल्सो गेटिंग एंड दोस न्यू कस्टमर्स ट्राई टू सैटिस्फाई देम, एक्सीड देयर एक्सपेक्टेशन, एक्सीड गेटिंग. सो व्हाट शुड बी डन, इंप्लीमेंट प्रोसेसेस फॉर मैनेजिंग कस्टमर कंप्लेंट्स इफेक्टिवली एंड इफिशिएंटली. हियर हियर इन दिस कस्टमर एंड मार्केट नॉलेज यू हैव टेकन द फीडबैक राइट, यस. एंड हियर व्हाट इज द सैटिस्फैक्शन, व्हाटएवर द फीडबैक, मे बी इट इज अ पॉजिटिव और नेगेटिव. अगर आपके पास जो भी नेगेटिव फीडबैक है दैट शुड बी क्रिएटेड ओवर हियर, सैटिस्फैक्शन शुड बी डन. सो दिस इज योर कस्टमर focus here. For the customer, 2 points are there: customer and market knowledge, customer relationship, satisfaction. A few other 4 points will be completing in the next class. Please start giving the attendance. If you have done with the attendance, you can leave my class. Thank you. Stay home. Stay safe.